Good afternoon, class. How are we doing today?
Good.
There you go. I love it. Uh-huh. All right, today we're going to demo a potato pie. You're going to need this potato pie for your midterm. We're going to have a simple pie dough, and it's going to be surrounded or encased in your bacon, your onions, your cheese, and your Idaho potatoes. All right, in here we have basically small pieces of butter. We have some salt and some all-purpose flour. What we're gonna do with this is we're gonna just break it up, all right? What we're doing here is friseeing it. We're pounding the butter into the flour, all right? We're slowly breaking it up. We're gonna keep the chunks of fat fairly small. I want a very mealy dough for this because we're gonna have some heavy cream in this mixture, this apres. That's a French term for mixtures. And what we're gonna do with that is, by having it a mealy dough rather than an ultra flaky dough, it'll be able to hold the liquids a little bit better. And that's why we're doing what we're doing. All right? And this term again is called friseeing. Just slowly putting this together. Now, this can also be made in a food processor, of course, but I don't know, for some reason I'd rather just clean a bowl rather than the whole darn food processor. All right, this is looking pretty good over here. All right, you'll notice that you can't, no visible chunks of fat like we've had in the past when we make some pie doughs that we're gonna fill with regular filling. All right, at this point, I'm liking the way this is looking over here. And we're gonna add some ice cold water. We're just gonna add enough water to bring this together. All right, we do not want this dough too wet. So we're gonna work it in very slowly, the water. It's better to be over-cautious than just throw caution to the wind and just pour. Because then your dough will get very, very tough, and it really won't be the flavor and taste sensations you're looking for. All right, it's starting to really come together now. I'm starting to like what I feel here. Yeah, we're there. I'll mix this a little bit, but I don't want to over-mix this. All right, now this is way more dough than you're gonna need for this, all right? And I gave you extra dough in case you make an error or two. All right, so at this point, I'm gonna literally take this apart like this. All right, I'm gonna flatten out the disc like we have in the past. We're gonna saran wrap this, put it in the fridge for 30 minutes, and then we can use this again. All right, we need autolase to kick in. Autolase is basically where the gluten and gliadin, the proteins in the flour in the presence of water that have been kneaded, need to relax. So you need at least 20 minutes to 30 minutes for autolase to kick in. All right, that's your first step. Thank you.